KVCE. Business Authority, 1160 AM. KVCE.
The information provided during this broadcast belongs to the show host and is for general informational purposes only. Nothing that is discussed or taken as legal advice for any individual case or situation. This information does not and is not intended to create an attorney-client relationship, nor does receipt of or listening to the information provided constitute an attorney-client relationship.
Welcome to the Believers in Business Hour on KVCE, AM 1160. It's time for Bar Talk with local trial lawyer Brad Parker, the attorney you want but hope you never need. Stay tuned, get informed, and get educated about your legal rights when you or a loved one have been seriously injured or harmed by the conduct of someone else or at the hands of an insurance company. Brad Parker has focused his law practice exclusively on trial work since becoming licensed in 1985 and is board certified in personal injury trial law by the Texas Board of Legal Specialization. And now, here's Bar Talk with Brad Parker, the attorney you want, but hope you never need.
Well, thank you. Good afternoon. I appreciate everybody tuning in to the Believers in Business Hour. Today, it's Bar Talk with Brad Parker. That's who I am, the attorney you want but hope you never need. I welcome you and welcome you to call in and visit with us on any subject that you might have, need an answer to a legal question or a legal issue that you are having. Please give me a call. I'll be happy to help you. If you can't call in right now, you want to call me at my office, always feel free to do that. I'll be happy to meet you for free, give you a free consultation on whatever issue you might have over the phone or in person if necessary. And you know, if I can't help you, I'm going to do my darndest to find somebody who can. My office number is 817-503-9200. Let me give you that again. That's my office, 817-503-9200. If this afternoon you'd like to call in and visit with me during the program, you can call in at 214-787-1160. That's 214-787-1160. Or email me. I check my emails during the breaks, and if we get questions sometimes, I'd be happy to answer those. My email is brad@parkerlawfirm.com. That's also my website, parkerlawfirm.com. Go on there. I have a lot of good information for you. May answer your question on some of the videos that I have. I try to keep it up to date and current and relevant. So I hope you'll take the time to visit the website or call in and ask me any questions that you might have. You know, this Believers in Business Hour is just growing and growing. It's every afternoon from 5 to 6. Here on AM 1160, and there's a brand new program. I think it just started yesterday, Boss Academy Radio. It's business ownership and success strategies with Paul Kirch. It's a great program if you haven't heard it yet. And of course, on Wednesdays, you get me, Brad Parker with Bar Talk. On Thursdays, you have the Family Law Hour with Frank and Donna. And if you have a family law matter, please give them a call and try to see if they can't answer your question. I know they can. They're both very great, very good lawyers and know exactly what they're talking about. Then on Fridays, close out the week with Money Matters. So I hope that you'll tune in to Believers in Business during the 5 to 6 hour. It's all local professionals trying to bring you the best and most up-to-date about the subject matter we're talking about. You know, I had the opportunity and the privilege. As a lawyer, we have to keep up to date on our what we call continuing legal education. And I got the opportunity last week on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday to be the course director for the Advanced Personal Injury Trial Law put on by the State Bar of Texas. And I've been so busy over the last several years, number of years, that I'll just catch seminars a little bit here, a little bit there. And this was a three-day seminar, and I was, like I said, I was the course director, which required me to stay there from start to finish. And I can't tell you how enjoyable that was. I don't know if it was because I wasn't in the office, and it was just nice being away for a couple of days. But no, what it really was is we just had so many excellent speakers, excellent topics, And you just forget sometimes how much is out there. And it's, the state bar requires us to have a minimum of, I believe it's 15 hours a year of continuing up-to-date education. And it was a great program. We had a lot of people. But one of the things that was talked about during the presentations, we had a speaker that visited with us about trucking accidents, the rise of trucking accidents, and some of the problems associated with them and some of the reasons why. So I thought I might focus my show a little bit today about some of the stuff I learned, stuff I knew. I handle a lot of trucking accidents, but sometimes you get so far into it, you have to step back and kind of see the forest through all the trees. And it was a good presentation and some interesting facts that sometimes you just overlook when you're down in the weeds doing some stuff. So I want to share that with you here in a little bit and visit with you, let you know, take any questions you might have. But the first thing I want to talk about today is something that I hit on and touched on just a little bit last week. But, it's the kids in hot cars and parents and caregivers who inadvertently, obviously, purely by accident, forget and leave their young children in a car during the summer months. It doesn't even have to be summer. Studies have shown that temperatures at 58 degrees are sufficient enough to cause kids to suffer heat stroke if they're left in the car long enough. And I was coming through the papers and I came across a couple of stories again that in Georgia someone had left their little 9-month-old baby in a car. There's another story out of Perry, Iowa, where a hospital CEO inadvertently left her daughter in the car. There's another one in Texas just the other day where a child was left in the car. And what's kind of interesting about it is, the tragedy of it all. But why does it happen? And how are states trying to handle it? And what can we do to help alleviate and prevent this most serious problem? And, one of the things that's very interesting is that in each of these situations, law enforcement officials have to make a determination of what they're going to do as a result of a child suffering heat stroke and dying. Again, it's all purely by accident. Most tragic event, a parent losing a child, especially because of their own negligence. I can't imagine anything worse than having to suffer through that. It's just unimaginable to me. But, put aside the issue of civil negligence, which, of course, there is civil negligence. You'd have a personal injury claim or wrongful death claim if a caregiver or somebody left your child or your neighbor left your child in the car. But put that aside, the states themselves are handling these in unusual ways. Some are pressing charges. Some are not pressing charges. And then the question is, of course, what does a jury do with it? But one of the things in looking at this subject that I found most intriguing was that there was a recent survey that came out called Safe Kids Worldwide. And this survey was done of 100 parents and caregivers who transport children ages 6 and under. And it was presented in Nashville at the National Lifesavers Conference on Highway Safety Priorities. It's an annual gathering of about 2,000 traffic safety advocates and professionals. But what's interesting or revealing or tragic is that the survey revealed that almost 7 in 10 parents said they've heard about these incidents where kids are left in cars, but they're still willing to leave their kids in the car, think it's okay. Oh, I'm just going to run in here for 2 seconds and leave the car running. Even some parents leave the cars running. That's just amazing. Then, of course, the other statistics that will blow you away is that 14% of parents, that's projected on almost 2 million parents transporting more than 3.3 million children, said they left intentionally their kids in the car. But 11% of the parents, more than 1.5 million, admit that they have forgotten Not that they intentionally left them, but they had just forgotten them in the car. The survey also showed that dads are almost three times more likely to leave a child alone in the car as opposed to moms. And, you know, when you look at the facts of some of these cases, you see that the reason why a child might get left behind is because they aren't the normal caregiver. They are taking the child to daycare out of the unusual, out of the ordinary, and they just get busy on their own deal. And they forget that a child is back there in back seat, turned around backwards. You know, these cases increased dramatically with airbags because we had to move the children to the back. You know, there's a couple of things you can do to make certain it doesn't happen to you. And one is put the child's bag in the front seat with you so that you see it automatically when you're getting out. Or better yet, put your cell phone in the back seat where the child is so that you have to grab your cell phone before you get out. I mean, nobody forgets their cell phone. And so those are just a couple of ideas. Be back with you here in just a few more minutes.
This is 1160 AM KVCE. KVCE, Dallas-Fort Worth's Business Authority.
Saturday mornings at 9, tune in for A Bridge to Care and Comfort, discussing caregiver issues and delving into all aspects of hospice care. Hosted by Army veteran Pete Persaud, a loving husband, father, and experienced respiratory care practitioner for 36 years, who has personally experienced the need for hospice care through the loss of his sister to cancer. This year alone, approximately 2.5 million Americans will die, and approximately 3 in 10 will need hospice care for their final weeks or months of life. A Bridge to Care and Comfort explores the emotional, psychological, and spiritual questions, as well as medical and financial ones, surrounding hospice care and caring for elders. Join us Saturday mornings at 9 for a program full of heartfelt, poignant, and humorous stories from families and staff. And most importantly, to learn why hospice care is so important to you, your loved ones, friends, and neighbors. A Bridge to Care and Comfort with Pete Persaud, your resource to compassionate end-of-life services. Saturday mornings at 9 on 1160 AM KVCE or online at kvceradio.com.
At Parker Law Firm, people matter. We have an unwavering commitment to people who have been seriously harmed by the negligence or wrongdoing of others. Our practice focuses on those who have been killed or seriously injured in major trucking or car accidents, or whose lives have been seriously disrupted by the bad faith conduct of an insurance company.
Hi, I'm Brad Parker, principal partner at Parker Law Firm. I'm board certified in personal injury trial law by the Texas Board of Legal Specialization. I'm also the immediate past president of the Texas Trial Lawyers Association. Our firm knows that when you or a loved one has been seriously injured in an accident caused by another person's negligence, you may not know where to go or who to trust. Our firm is built on years of trial experience, a tradition of personal service, and a reputation for zealous representation of our clients. We're dedicated to providing experienced and comprehensive legal assistance to individuals and their families during their times of need.
Let the attorneys from Parker Law Firm help you. Get a free consultation. Give us a call, 817-503-9200, or visit parkerlawfirm.com.
Listen to what people say about philsgang.com.
You know, I'd listened to you on the radio, and I thought, oh, I love his sense of humor. He can make trading fun. I guess this is the guy I'm going to learn to chart with. The Phil's Gang. Phil, I have learned so much. It is absolutely incredible.
For a successful investing plan for any time frame, from current income to your retirement security, philsgang.com puts you on the path to making profits in the stock market.
You make it so simple if they can really grasp what you're trying to get through to them.
Only philsgang.com's Phil Grandy and Donald Cogswell teach you, coach you, and guide you to investing confidence.
Being a gang member, and you're showing us how to trade in any market, which gives you such a feeling of confidence.
Why pay an outrageous fee for a one-time weekend investing class when philsgang.com provides daily investing webinars, alerts, and investing advice for only $49.95 a month, and all material is archived? Go to philsgang.com or call 877-600-4264. That's 877-600-4264. philsgang.com.
Real estate accounts for more millionaires than any other investment vehicle. Lifestyles Unlimited is an education and mentor group that for over 20 23 years has taken people by the hand and taught them how to build wealth and passive income streams. Our students have won Investor of the Year awards 8 of the last 8 years. We offer a free workshop for anyone considering investing in real estate. 866-945-6565. That's 866-945-6565. Or visit lifestylesunlimited.com. That's lifestylesunlimited.com.
I'm TJ. My mom is Basketball Hall of Famer Nancy Lieberman. Going to her camp taught me how to play basketball the right way. Tell them, Mom.
Join us at the World Ventures Nancy Lieberman Basketball Camp.
We have 4 great sessions
this summer at Fieldhouse USA in Frisco. We'll skill drill. We'll build your confidence and self-esteem. We'll take your game to the next level. Sign up. Call 972-473-2121 or go to nancylieberman.com.
Brought to you by the Nancy Lieberman and World Ventures Foundation. See you there.
From Wall Street to the Metroplex, this is 1160 AM KVCE, Dallas-Fort Worth's Business Authority.
Welcome back to Believers in Business Bar Talk with Texas Board Certified Personal Injury Trial Lawyer, Brad Parker, right here on AM 1160 KVCE. Have questions? Get answers. Call in at 214-787-1160. That's 214-787-1160. You can check it out online at kvceradio.com. Brought to you by the Parker Law Firm.
Welcome back. I appreciate everybody hanging around to hear a little bit more of Bar Talk and the issues that we have to talk about today. I too want to encourage you to call in if you have any comments or questions that you might have to 214-787-1160, or you can email me at brad@parkerlawfirm.com. During our break, we had Pete, who I understand is in the medical field, who called in and wanted to add a few comments. Pete, are you there?
Yes, I am. How are you this evening?
I'm very good. And yourself?
I'm doing fine. Just getting ready for this rainstorm, it looks like.
Yeah. You know, the weather's sure been nice the last couple of days, but it sure doesn't stop overheating by young kids if they were stuck in a car.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yes, I just want to comment on that. And my hat's off to your show, what you're trying to accomplish in terms of the public awareness of, heat and kids in cars. Parents leaving their kids in cars. I am a parent myself. I just want to say that think about even adults in their car with no air conditioning. You know how it feels like. I'm thinking about a kid from a toddler to a 5 or 6 year old in a car with no air conditioning, or just being in the car for about 2 or 3 hours. You know what happens then?
Yeah, and the studies will show that it can be as soon as 20 or 30 minutes that a car can raise
right.
from 90 degrees to 108 degrees in about 10 to 15 minutes. So this can happen extremely fast, and I believe this. You correct me if I'm wrong, but kids can become susceptible to heat stroke 5 times faster than adults.
That is correct, because their brains aren't developed as adults, you see. So, yes, they can. They will develop that heat stroke very, very quickly versus adults or even people in their 20s or teens. So, again, it's very important for what you're trying to accomplish in terms of your topic there, where parents need to be aware of their surroundings.
Yes, and you know, if they'll take a couple of tips that I kind of had to hurriedly suggest, put your cell phone in that back seat if you're transporting a kid. Because then that way, when you get out of the car, you're going to check for your cell phone, and you have to go to the back seat, or put a bag in front of the front car or in the front seat with you, so that when you look down when you're about to get out, you'll see the child's diaper bag. Those types of things will help remind you that you've got a young one on board, and your busy day might have kept you from paying attention like you should have.
Well, yeah, that's correct. There's some very good tips.
Well,
and all the people, go ahead. I'm sorry.
No. Go ahead.
Yeah. There's some very good tips that adults should be aware of in terms of their surroundings again. And you're right in terms of putting something in the back seat, so where you're obligated to open that back seat and to get your items. Yeah. That's very good.
Well, Pete, I sure appreciate you calling in. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much.
If you have a question you would like answered, or if you'd like to make a comment, please feel free to call in at 214 787-1160. You know, this is a topic that we could fill the entire program with, and you'll probably hear me talk about it again. There, summertime just lends itself, it seems like, to so much more fun, but so many other dangers that we don't otherwise have, from leaving kids in hot cars to swimming without life vests. You know, such a dangerous thing to do. But today what I would like to move on to and talk about just a little bit is, why do we have an increase in the number of 18-wheeler accidents in this state? This is a trend that Texas is experiencing at an alarming rate. I was just looking at some statistics earlier today, and in 2010, there were 284 fatalities on the Texas roadways that involved crashes or injuries involving commercial motor vehicles. 284, basically involving commercial vehicles. That's in 2010. Fast forward to 2012, which is the most recent year I could get the statistics for. 526 deaths involving commercial vehicles. That's not quite, but almost twice as many over a two-year period. That's astounding. If you also just look at the numbers, just the total crashes of involving commercial motor vehicles, that number in 2010 was 15,676. That's 15,676. 2 years later, in 2012, that number rose to 26,463. Again, I don't have a calculator right in front of me, but that's about a 75% increase in the number of big rig or commercial vehicle accidents on our Texas highways. And you got to be asking yourself, why? Why is this? You know, we know we've got them everywhere. I am the immediate past president of the Texas Trial Lawyers Association, and I've been heavily involved both as the president-elect and as legislative chair for a number of years. And it required me to travel to Austin on a weekly basis. And, you know, just driving I-35 on a weekly basis, there literally would be times, depending upon the time of day or the day of the week, that there were literally as many trucks on the road as there were cars. And, you know, when you get involved in an automobile accident with a truck, you don't fare too well. Trucks typically can weigh, a fully loaded truck, approximately 80,000 pounds. A car, on the other hand, weighs about 4,000 pounds, and that's a heavy car. I mean, most cars, that's like an SUV or pickup truck. Most are significantly under that weight. So if you think about just the pure mass, you know, if you do a little algebra calculations that he learned back in high school and college, you know, a 80,000-pound vehicle moving 5 miles per hour is about 400,000 pounds per mile hour, compared to a car, which is about 1/20th of that, about 2,000 pounds mile per hour. The sheer mass of a truck when it hits a car results in considerable devastation to the automobile, the car or the pickup truck, as opposed to what happens to the actual truck itself, the 18-wheeler. That in and of itself is one of the reasons, if you're involved in one of these wrecks, it's not going to be good. There's going to be some negative outcome from it, and if you're lucky, you might survive it. But that doesn't really answer the question as to why. Why do we have such an increase in the number of trucking accidents and thus trucking deaths, related deaths, in the state? And, You know, there's a lot of reasons why truckers have accidents to begin with. I mean, obviously, the reason that the death rate is higher is, like I said, the mass, just the pure mass of the vehicle is much more. But you also have sleep deprivation and fatigue as being a serious problem for truckers. You know, if you drive at night or over the nighttime period, you're fatigued. Your sleep pattern is disrupted. And the time of day is the largest factor to contribute to fatigue. So when you get out of your normal sleep pattern, you start to have fatigue. But other reasons, load shifting, texting. The trucks are full of computers and text, then of course just texting and mobile phones. But that didn't answer the question of why are we having more, and I'd like to discuss that with you when we come back from break. I'm Brad Parker. This is Bar Talk. I'm the attorney you want, but hope you never need.
This is 1160 AM, KVCE, Dallas-Fort Worth's Business Authority.
Have we got a show for you? Join Tony Becerra with the Job Search Solution Show Monday through Friday mornings at 7:30 on 1160 AM KVCE. As president of Babich & Associates, Tony Becerra has authored two best-selling books and has frequently appeared as an expert guest on radio and TV talk programs, offering advice on how to find a job or change careers in this difficult economy. The Job Search Solution Show, weekday mornings at 7:30, right here on Dallas-Fort Worth's Business Authority, 1160 AM KVCE.
When I first got out of law school, I went to work for a big downtown Fort Worth law firm. It was a prestigious job, but I never felt fulfilled professionally, helping banks and companies. I didn't have that fulfillment that kind of drove me to be a lawyer to begin with. And the more I saw and learned, the more I realized that maybe being in the big firm wasn't the right thing for me. So after about 5 years, I went out on my own to kind of start doing some personal injury work and some what we call insurance bad faith, because you get the opportunity to help real people. Your efforts and your success makes a difference in their lives. And that is very satisfying and very rewarding to me. And it drives me every morning when I wake up to be able to help people. The rewarding times after a case is settled, the cards I get from clients, just to say, thank you, you made a difference in my life. I never really got that from the CEOs of the banks that I represented. It is truly rewarding to know that you've made a difference in someone's life and you've really helped them out.
How is your retirement account looking? Or how about your savings account? If you're tired of watching your family's financial future disappear and are left wondering why your money manager can't seem to keep it from happening, then come learn how to take control of your own finances. Since the Bible teaches to lay aside for your grandchildren, you need a way to do just that. Attend our two-day course and learn the system that pastor and businessman David Mitchell developed based on principles found in the Bible, along with his solid background in trading in the stock market. You can learn this system just like thousands of others have across the country. Be the person that your great-grandchildren will be talking about. New venture on Wall Street. Build your legacy.
The next seminar is August 1st and 2nd at Crown Plaza North Dallas, 14315 Midway Road in Addison, and Sheridan Fort Worth, 1701 Commerce Street. To register, call 877-907-TRADE. That's 877-907-TRADE. Or go to NVOWS.com. That's NVOWS.com.
Okay, you own a car. You just bought a car. Now who's servicing your car? Hey, Kurt Chase here, host of the Automotive Edge radio show for Driver's Edge Auto Repair. With consumers keeping their cars over 10 years on average, service and maintenance decisions need to be smart ones. At Driver's Edge Auto Repair, your knowledge of the repairs make for the most smart and cost-effective decisions. With the best warranty in the business, 3-year, 36,000-mile nationwide warranty, and the top ASE-certified mechanics doing the work, trust your car, truck, or SUV to Driver's Edge Auto Repair. With 100% customer satisfaction, shuttle service, and no interest financing on those major repairs you may need, go to mydriversedge.com. That's mydriversedge.com for a location nearest you. With over 25 years in the auto industry, I know auto repair, and that's why I use and recommend Driver's Edge Auto Repair. Go to mydriversedge.com. That's mydriversedge.com.
This just in, death, destruction, and violence. Film at 11.
Come on.
Is all the news really bad? How about some good news in your daily routine? You'll find it when you log on to Christianity.com. They've got great devotionals, terrific Bible study tools, quizzes, and links to the day's most inspiring stories from around the web. Get good news every day when you set your homepage to Christianity.com. Make a difference in your internet life. Christianity.com.
You're listening to 1160 AM KVCE.
Welcome back to Bar Talk with Brad Parker. You can check it out online at kvcradio.com. Brought to you by the Parker Law Firm. Have questions? Get answers. Call in at 214-787-1160. That's 214-787-1160. What'd you say? I won't
pay. Rather play. Welcome back. You have Brad Parker here, the attorney you want, but hope you never need. And this is Bar Talk. I encourage you to call in and visit with me. I'm at 214-787-1160. That's the number you could get on with me right now. Of course, if you're driving around and can't call, feel free to call me at my office. My office number is 817-503-9200. I'll be happy to consult with you for free about any issue that we're talking about today or any legal issue you might have. I want to encourage you to give me a call, and if for any reason I can't help you, I'm going to try to find somebody who can. I don't want you to go away not being able to call somebody. Also, look at me on our web. It's www.parkerlawfirm.com. You know, before we drifted away after our segment there a minute ago, we were talking about things that cause different problems, and I was talking about fatigue and just being overworked, and someone called in during the commercial break who was married to a truck driver, and she indicated that one of the biggest problems that they have is fatigue, and that is a real problem. And what's out there to help these drivers, you know, sometimes the employers want to push them, but you know, they fortunately the statutes, the Motor Carrier Acts, prescribe certain periods in which drivers can drive, for how long they can drive. I don't have those right in front of me, but basically they can't be actually behind the wheel. I think it's more than 9 hours in any 14-hour period of time. And then after so many, I think it's 60 hours in any seven-day period, they must take off a certain prescribed period. Again, the Federal Motor Carrier Safety Regulations provide those details. And so drivers can always have that to fall back on to help them, you know, not be forced to drive more than they have to. But one of the things that we're talking about and what we were talking about earlier was the numbers, just the sheer numbers. As I mentioned earlier, you know, in 2010, there were approximately 284 crashes involving commercial vehicles, most likely, you know, large interstate carriers or interstate carriers. There were 284 deaths involved in those crashes. By 2 years later, 2012, there was 526, a tremendous increase, almost double. And if you look at just the number of injury crashes, just the serious injury crashes, there were 2,339 in 2010, and there were 3,745 in 2012. So there you have an increase of at least about 75%, if my rough math is right. And then if you just look at the total crashes, they're up from 15,000 to over 26,000 just in that 2 year period. So what's causing all the more trucks to be on our roadways? And I would submit to you that it's the oil patch. It's the tremendous volume of oil and gas work, which has made our state extremely prosperous, but it's also got a necessary evil to it, and that is more trucks. More trucks transporting gas, oil, pipe, supplies. You know, if you were to look at Texas alone. Texas is 30% of the producer of 30% of the United States natural gas, and 30% of its oil. If Texas were a nation, we would be the 14th largest oil-producing nation in the world, and we would be the third largest gas-producing nation, only behind Russia and the other 49 states combined. So think about that for a minute. Texas is just huge. Over the last 10 years, the oil and gas production in this state has skyrocketed. And that's with the new drilling techniques to the Barnett Shale, to the Eagle Ford Shale, to the areas out in Midland, Odessa area. Those have exploded. And likewise, the truck traffic has exploded in those areas as well. If you just look and compare stats for the various different counties, I'll give you an example of some of the differences between Dallas County, for instance, has about 0.5%, 0.5% of all fatalities in Dallas County, or I should back up, I said that wrong, of all crashes, cars, trucks, whatever, of all those crashes in Dallas County, less than 0.5% results in a death. If you look at Harris County, home of Houston, it is 0.4% of all their crashes result in death. The same holds true for Tarrant County. It is about little less than 0.5%. Now, Dallas and Houston and Fort Worth aren't big. I mean, Fort Worth to some degree kind of is, but they aren't big oil and gas producers. But if you look on the other hand to, for instance, Andrews County out in West Texas, there's 4.9% of all traffic accidents result in a fatality. That number moves from less than 0.5% in Dallas and Harris and Tarrant County to almost 5% in Andrews County. If you look at Ector County, it's 1.5%, three times higher than what it is in Dallas. Likewise, if you look at Johnson County, just south of us, it's twice as high as Tarrant County. Johnson County is a big producer of oil and gas. Kaufman County is at almost 2% of all crashes. So you've got a large degree. But then when you even bump it up from there and look at in those counties that have high death rates, the death rate even gets higher when you look at those death rates involving commercial vehicles. It goes up to 12% from 5% in Andrews County. Now, that's what I'm saying here is that the chances of you dying in a truck wreck in Andrews County is 12%. In Dallas County, it's 0.5%, 0.5%. If you go to Hidalgo County, it's 2.3%. Ector County, it's 4.5%. So the statistics are bearing out that the reason why we're having more deaths, and deaths not just in traffic accident, but deaths involving trucks, is because there's simply more trucks on the road. And the reason there's more trucks on the road is because of the oil and gas production. Again, it's a necessary evil to the prosperity that the oil and gas business brings to us. Whether you're for or against oil and gas production, it has been a boon to the Texas economy. It's been a boon from more employment, more goods and services being sold, but that means more trucks on the road. And you've got to absolutely try and protect yourself when traveling the highways. And how do you do that? How do you protect yourself against a 80,000 pound vehicle that is traveling 70, 80 miles an hour down the freeway? Well, I'd suggest to you that the best way is to get out of the way. Get as far away from them as you possibly can. You know, I've said on this show and to anybody that'll listen to me that the most dangerous thing you do every single day of your life is get behind the wheel of your car. Because if you get in an automobile accident traveling at any kind of high rate of speed, the chances of being injured are pretty high. But if you get involved in one of those accidents with an 18-wheeler, the chances of being seriously injured, if not killed, is extremely high. And so, you know, the first thing you can do is just stay away from them the best you can. But as I observed, you know, just driving back and forth to Austin, it's hard to do. There are so many trucks on the highways. It's very hard to do. And we have all kinds of reasons why these trucks have the wrecks, from fatigue to load shifting. So, you know, there's a couple of other things you can do if you are to protect yourself if you are involved in one of these accidents. And I would like to talk to you about that when we come back from break. I'm Brad Parker. This is Bar Talk, AM 1160, KBCE, DFW's Business Authority.
Business Authority, 1160 AM, KVCE.
Is not an actor, but a real-life story from Trinity Debt Management.
When our daughter Emma was born, we took a look at our credit card debt. It was not a good situation. We had been running up balances for quite some time, and it became a crisis. Finally, my wife Vicky said, call Trinity.
If you're in debt and you need help, call Trinity at 1-800-990-6976 to talk to a certified counselor.
We called them, they contacted all of our creditors, they stopped the collections calls, they got the interest reduced, and they put us on a plan for success.
Trinity will consolidate your bills, stop collections calls, wipe out late fees, reduce your interest, and improve your credit score. You'll save thousands.
We are now completely debt-free, and we will never be in the spot we were again, thanks to Trinity.
If your debt has you down, call Trinity at 1-800-990-6976.
My name is John.
I'm Vicky.
And I'm Emma.
And we're debt-free for keeps.
That's 1-800-990-6976.
I'm Rick Plum, CFP with RJL Wealth Management. If you watched our latest webcast explaining Social Security strategies, you learned there are so many variables that can affect how much you'll receive, how and when you'll file for your benefits and your spouse's benefits, the different scenarios if you're widowed, divorced, or remarried.
Then there's the bigger picture. How do your Social Security benefits work in an integrated investment strategy along with your 401ks, IRAs, and other assets so they're all working together?
That's what an RJL Wealth Management Bucket Strategy is designed to do. The strategy integrates your investments and provides a customized strategy-first solution for you.
A complimentary consultation with an RJL Wealth Management financial planner can help you develop a bucket strategy that incorporates Social Security benefits. Schedule a consultation today. Call 800-644-1150. 800-644-1150. 800-644-1150. Rick Plum is a registered representative of and offers securities through Lucia Securities, LLC, member SIPC, and affiliate of RJL Wealth Management, LLC.
At Parker Law Firm, people matter. We have an unwavering commitment to people who have been seriously harmed by the negligence or wrongdoing of others. Our practice focuses on those who have been killed or seriously injured in major trucking or car accidents, or whose lives have been seriously disrupted by the bad faith conduct of an insurance company.
Hi, I'm Brad Parker, principal partner at Parker Law Firm. I'm board certified in personal injury trial law by the Texas Board of Legal Specialization. I'm also the immediate past president of the Texas Trial Lawyers Association. Our firm knows that when you or a loved one has been seriously injured in an accident caused by another person's negligence, you may not know where to go or who to trust. Our firm is built on years of trial experience, a tradition of personal service, and a reputation for zealous representation of our clients. We're dedicated to providing experienced and comprehensive legal assistance to individuals and their families during their times of need.
Let the attorneys from Parker Law Firm help you. Get a free consultation. Give us a call, 817-503-9200, or visit parkerlawfirm.com.
Investors who want to maximize their opportunities and minimize their losses, turn to philsgang.com. Beginner or seasoned investor,
PhilsGang.com is where you learn to invest using professional-level skills and strategies, regardless of your experience and investing goals.
I've been a member for about a year, and I'm this year I'm up around 60% on my portfolio.
I'm a new gang member. I'm up like 15% in 3 months. Thank you so much.
Thank you for giving my confidence back in trading.
For only $49.95 a month, you will have access to all Phil's Gang programs, special alerts, the daily investing class, and all material is archived. So why don't you take care of your financial opportunities with PhilsGang.com? Operators are standing by. Simply call 877-600-4264. 877-600-4264. That's 877-600-4264. Or go to PhilsGang.com. That's PhilsGang.com today.
From Wall Street to the Metroplex,
this is 1160 AM
KVCE.
Welcome back to Believers in Business Bar Talk with Texas Board Certified Personal Injury Trial Lawyer Brad Parker, right here on AM 1160 KVCE. Have questions? Get answers. Call in at 214-787-1160. That's 214-787-1160. You can check it out online at kvceradio.com. Brought to you by the Parker Law Firm.
Thanks for hanging out with me this afternoon on Bar Talk. We're talking about the truck wrecks and why there's so many more truck wrecks than there have been in the past. But, you know, what do you do? What do you do when a loved one has been killed or seriously injured in a truck wreck, or you have been involved in a truck wreck, or any wreck for that matter, but especially a truck wreck? The first thing you have got to do, I implore you to do it, other than seek medical care, of course, but is you've got to call a lawyer. You must get a lawyer involved. I promise you that the first thing that truck driver did after he ran over your loved one was call his home office. And within minutes, that home office has dispatched a accident scene investigator and their minions out there to start taking statements, to start taking measurements, to start viewing the scene, taking pictures, all in preparation of the lawsuit they know that's ultimately going to come. And even though it may be 2 or 3 days or weeks after that we get involved, the sooner that a plaintiff's injury lawyer, someone like me, can get involved, get our investigators, our accident reconstructionists out to the scene, the better. There are so many things to be obtained. And these trucking companies are responsible for their drivers. You know, they've got rules and regulations. And one of the things that we have found in a number of cases I've been involved in is that the trucking companies are hiring drivers without doing thorough investigative and qualification background checks. I had a case, I've still got it, up in Oklahoma involving the wheels falling off of a 18-wheeler trailer, bouncing over the freeway. Imagine this if you can. Two of those wheels, you know, hundreds of pounds apiece, bouncing over the median on an interstate highway and coming at you from the opposite direction. Needless to say, it was a horrible, tragic incident. But the thing that we found out during the course of this is that the driver had his license suspended many months earlier, and the employer was still letting him drive. We've got other cases where fatigue, the driver had been driving more than he should have and just drifted off the roadway and ran over a car that was disabled with the driver and its occupant in the car. We need those driver's files. We look at them. We see what kind of qualifications. There are drivers who would have never been hired had the employer just done a basic, what we call a very basic background search to find out that their driver had been arrested 3 times for marijuana possession. You know, those kinds of things. There's too many trucks and not enough drivers, I guess is what I'm saying. So oftentimes we find that they're there. So if you or a loved one is involved in an accident like this, it's just critically important that you contact an attorney, a board-certified personal injury trial attorney, a board-certified personal injury trial lawyer who has experience at handling truck wrecks, who has experience at trying lawsuits, who doesn't practice personal injury trial law along with probate, wills, marriage dissolution or divorces, and real estate. Those kind of guys you don't want to hire. Those men and women aren't specialists in the field of personal injury. You need to find someone who can focuses their practice, does focus their practice on the personal injury aspect. And the sooner you call me or you call a board-certified personal injury trial lawyer, the better off you're going to be in the long run. You know, we see a lot of the same attorneys in these cases. And when you hire someone like me that has been involved in these cases over the years, we have relationships with the attorneys who typically represent many of these trucking companies or vendors who have their own trucks. And we have an ability to get information informally. They know they have to give it to us anyway, ultimately, but we have the ability to find out important things right off the bat so that we know what we're looking at. We can get our investigators out so that when they download what they call the little black box, we can get that data and be sure that it was downloaded in a secure and accurate way so that none of the data was compromised. You know, we need to be out there as soon as possible to inspect the cab, the interior of the truck. What was in there? What's the status of the computer? What is in that truck? You'd be amazed at what you see in some of these trucks before they get an opportunity to clean them up. So it's just vitally important that as soon as you possibly can, you get a lawyer who is fighting for you. Because I promise you, that trucking company has got insurance companies, they've got accident reconstructionists, they've got investigators that are on the scene before the police even left the scene. They're there that fast. And so it's just absolutely critical that you do this. And some of the other things that we look for, it's just not necessarily the driver's qualification files, but their logs. You know, oftentimes drivers use, I say oftentimes, I have been involved in cases and know of cases where drivers have used dual logs, you know, that they have one set of logs and then another set of logs, kind of a behind the scenes set that will truly show how long they've been driving. There's also requirements on the part of the trucking companies that they've got to keep these trucks maintained. You know, there was an interesting statistic I heard the other day that, you know, the Texas Department of Public Safety will pull these trucks over just to inspect the vehicles to be sure that they are up to snuff, so to speak. In the state of Texas, 22% of those vehicles are not. They're taken out of service by the DPS because they're not up to snuff. However, in some of these smaller counties where you have a lot of oil and gas activity, I'll use Dimmitt as an example. Dimmitt County, that number was 58%. Think about that. 58% of the vehicles they stopped to inspect, they took out of service right there on the spot because they did not pass muster. So, you know, that's the other thing that the attorneys will look for immediately is let's get the maintenance records on these trucks. Let's find out when they were last serviced. Did they change the brakes? Is that why the wheels fell off? When did they change the brakes? Did they retighten the lock nuts? Was there an inspection of the truck? How much weight were they carrying? Did they have overweight? How was the load secured? Was this a tip-over case? Did the load shift? You might remember just a few weeks ago, a truck fell over on the overpass in Fort Worth full of cattle. Now, that's kind of hard to keep cattle still, but still, the point was he was going too fast when he navigated that turn and caused himself to fall over. There's all kinds of equipment on the truck to show how long it's been running, when it's been, where it is. Where are the gas receipts? Do the gas receipts match the mileage statements? Do the gas receipts match the log that the truck driver has? These are all questions that have to be asked and have to be asked early to see to what degree was this an accident that could have easily been avoided if just the pure, simple regulations had been followed by the employer or the driver himself. And in the country and in Texas in particular, the trucking companies can't escape liability because they hire a driver as an independent contractor. They're responsible for it. So all of these things are extremely important to look at. And one of the main reasons you want to get a competent, board-certified personal injury trial lawyer involved just as fast as possible. I know that your loved one is you're going through a very traumatic and terrible time because of the injuries or death that has been suffered, but it's just absolutely important, and I can't tell you enough. My time is up today. I want to remind you that tomorrow night we have the Family Law Hour with Frank and Donna. So be sure and tune in to them if you have any family law questions. And also, coming up next is the Bloomberg. AM 1160 KBCE. This has been Bar Talk, and I'm Brad Parker.
Thanks for joining us for Bar Talk with local trial lawyer Brad Parker, the attorney you want but hope you never need. Join us again next week when you, the listener, can become more educated about your legal rights and your Seventh Amendment right to a civil justice system. Until then, if you are in need of legal advice or services, contact local attorney Brad Parker at 817-503-9200 or on his website at parkerlawfirm.com.
KVCE.
At Parker Law Firm, people matter. We have an unwavering commitment to people who have been seriously harmed by the negligence or wrongdoing of others. Our practice focuses on those who have been killed or seriously injured in major trucking or car accidents, or whose lives have been seriously disrupted by the bad faith conduct of an insurance company.
Hi, I'm Brad Parker, principal partner at Parker Law Firm. I'm board certified in personal injury trial law by the Texas Board of Legal Specialization. I'm also the immediate past president of the Texas Trial Lawyers Association. Our firm knows that when you or a loved one has been seriously injured in an accident caused by another person's negligence, you may not know where to go or who to trust. Our firm is built on years of trial experience, a tradition of personal service, and a reputation for zealous representation of our clients. We're dedicated to providing experienced and comprehensive legal assistance to individuals and their families during their times of need.
Let the attorneys from Parker Law Firm help you. Get a free consultation. Give us a call, 817-503-9200, or visit parkerlawfirm.com.